Howdy-dowdy-diddle-um-day, howdy-dowdy-diddle-um-day. Good evening, and thank you so much for coming out to our high school fall concerts. This is the first in a long time. We used to split our concerts up where we had an intermediate high school and an advanced high school concert. We thought it'd be a little fun to change things up and put everybody in the mix together so you get to hear the full progression of our program from beginning to end. So it's gonna be an exciting night. We still have a few groups to go still. But again, I wanna take a second just to thank everyone here, parents, students, family members, friends, for coming out and supporting us tonight. A big thanks to our tech friends, backstage friends for helping as well. We have a musical coming up in about a month. So at this point of the concert, I'd love to bring out two of our cast members from Cinderella the Musical to sing for you. Second to thank our Haslett Choir Boosters organization, all of the parents, community members, businesses that helped to put our program book together. If you have not gotten one of these, there's plenty on the aisles and up top as well in the music stands. But this is a great memento, but also kind of a showing of all the people that are supporting our choirs, pictures of your students and the choirs that they reside in. Again, it's just a really great pleasure to have such a wonderful book here. This just kind of sets us above the rest that we have our own book to kind of celebrate our students and celebrate our local businesses and family members that support us. I want to draw your attention as you're looking there that Cinderella tickets are already on sale, and we put a handy dandy QR code for you to scan to purchase your tickets early so that you don't get caught at the door and there's no seats. So please make sure you do so. Get your tickets ordered as soon as possible. We'd love to have you here for an amazing night of musical amazement. Without further ado, I would like to introduce the men's ensemble.
lamps trimmed and burning. The time is drawing nigh. Keep your lamps trimmed and burning. Keep your lamps trimmed and burning. Keep your lamps trimmed and burning. The time is drawing nigh. Yes.
We only have one more choir left, but before that, I'd like to take a moment to introduce you to our booster president, and she's going to talk to you a little bit about the choir boosters, what they've provided, such as this beautiful piece of work, and much more coming for your students. So, Cassie, I'll let you take the stage for a second.
Choir Booster President, and I just want to take a moment to talk to you about the Choir Boosters and how you can help and what we do. So two things that we do is raise money and volunteer. And for the raising money part, as you saw coming in, the program books is our fall fundraiser. So thanks again to everyone for participating, for being a sponsor, for getting an ad from a business, for a senior dedication, and all of the collecting of all the things, and we really couldn't do it without the whole community, and so I'm really, really grateful to all of you for that. It was very, very successful. I can tell you that at this point, we raised nearly $10,000 for the fall fundraiser, so that's really exciting. So some of the things we raise money for are for the annual choir camp that happens right before the school year starts to get all the students back together and get them excited about the school year coming up, to practice a little and get back into it. Uniforms, choir council activities throughout the year, and scholarships for the students to take vocal lessons. The New York trip that's happening this year, woo-hoo! And the instrumentalists and accompanists that perform here with us. So those are some of the main things that we earn money for. The other way that we earn the money is the spring fundraiser, which is our silent auction, which is really fun. The students get to put together themed baskets, and people get in bidding wars, and it's just really fun. And you get a prize at the end, right, if you win. So that's pretty cool, too. And we promise as boosters that as long as both of those programs keep going strong, we promise not to make you buy wrapping paper or pies, all right? So that is our promise to you. So then the other thing I wanted to mention is the volunteer piece of this. We sometimes need parents to volunteer for activities. Recently we went to the cider mill and we needed a few parents to help with that and be chaperones, to help with uniform fittings. And at the end of the year we have to clean the uniforms, things like that. So we have a brand new website. It's HaslettChoirBoosters.com. HaslettChoirBoosters.com, I'm saying it twice because I don't want you to forget. It's very simple. And on that website, you can click the contact us and give us your personal information, just your name and email. And then you can be put on the volunteer list so that when volunteer opportunities come up, we can send an email out to everyone. And if you're available, you can come and help us. And we usually just need a few parents here and there, but it's a really great way to stay engaged and to know what's going on and to volunteer if you have time. The other way that you can get involved with the Choir Boosters is to come to the monthly meetings. You don't have to come every time. You can pop in when you have time, but it's usually the second Wednesday of the month at 7 p.m. in the Viking Room, right here in the high school. So I think that's all I have for you tonight. Thanks so much for your time. Back to choir.
Thank you, Cassie, and thank you, Boosters, for all the hard work that you've put in over the years to help support our students in a financial sense to help us continue to grow this wonderful program. The last group coming up to you is Chorale. I want to make sure to make a mention of them before they come on the stage. The three pieces they are performing are in preparation for their performance at the 2024 Michigan Music Conference. Choir selected to perform at the statewide convention for music teachers, about 2,000, serves as a model of choral excellence and are expected to set quality standards for that year as they're preparing. The last time we've had a group perform at the Michigan Music Conference was Men's Chorale in 2015. So again, these three pieces Chorale's performing for you tonight are in preparation for that performance January 26th at Grand Rapids, or in Grand Rapids, at the J.W. Marriott Ballroom. Without further ado, Chorale, please come take the stage. Thank you.
Thank you. Thousands.